It was fun, it was entertaining, it was dramatic, and our four takeaways from the Saints' third straight win begin with what's different about the Saints' October perfection this season. If it hasn't felt as easy, there is a reason. In 2017, the Saints were a perfect 4-0 in October, in 18, 3-0, in 19, 4-0, and they just wrapped up a 3-0 this year. That's an incredible 14-0 over the last 4 years. But the difference is the average margin of victory in 17 was 13 points. In 18, it was 12. In 19, it was 11. This year, the Saints are winning by an average margin of just 4. This year, it hasn't been smooth. It's been a fight. And for the second game in a row, the Saints got a break on a kick. And Joey Sly's kick might be the greatest kick in NFL history that missed. At number three, there's a sports cliche, next man up. I'm not crazy about it, because Sean Payton's job isn't just to plug the next guy in. It's to maximize what the next guy does well. It's more like adapt or die. And Sunday, Payton adapted. There is no next man up to replace these two guys. Mike Thomas and Emmanuel Sanders have combined for exactly 1,100 catches, more than 13,000 yards. So who stepped up? It was two undrafted guys, Marquez Callaway and Deontay Harris. Before Sunday's game, this pair had combined for a grand total of 18 catches for 129 yards. But then Harris had his biggest game as a receiver, 4 catches, 46 yards, and that big touchdown before halftime. Callaway led the Saints with 10 targets. He caught 8 of them. The Saints used Callaway's football IQ. He found holes in the Panthers' zone, and they used Harris's quickness. The Saints adapted, and it worked. At number two, Marcus Davenport is making a massive difference. His return brought the season's best pass rush against the Chargers. Now, Teddy Bridgewater did do a terrific job avoiding the Saints' rush until the final 2 minutes of the game, when Davenport got that sack that pushed Carolina out of field goal range. Now, the defensive breakdowns continue to be maddening, and they are definitely a cause for concern going forward. But if Davenport can continue to improve the overall pass rush, that will certainly help the back end. And at number one, getting used to the new Saints offense has been an adjustment, but going back to adapt or die, for this offense to maximize its personnel, the Saints have to use this guy a lot, and they have to run the ball a lot, and they are learning that as we go. Sunday, the Saints rushed as a team 29 times for 138 yards. That's 4.8 yards per carry. In 6 games, they've now rushed for more than 120 yards 3 times, and for at least 4.8 yards per carry 3 times in 16 games. Last year, the Saints only went for 120 3 times all year, and for 4.8 only once all year. It's not as sexy as a 60-yard bomb, but the strength of the 2020 Saints offense looks like it's on the ground. And in their two biggest rushing games of the season against the Panthers and the Lions, because they ran it so effectively, they put up ridiculous third down conversion rates. That's the benefit of running it well. They were never over 70% on third down in any game last year. The overall athleticism of the Saints offensive line, teamed up with two terrific backs, makes for an old school recipe that is working. And that is my number one takeaway from the Saints' win over the Panthers.